بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبد الله الأمين صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين ومن دعا بدعوته إلى يوم الدين. And welcome to our fifth episode of our Ramadan reflections on this month of the Quran, the month of Ramadan. And today we have a reflection on verses number 34 and 35 of Surah At-Tawbah. And these two verses speak about the punishment of those who keep and store their money, gold and silver, and they don't spend it for the sake of Allah, that these people will be punished with the same money on the Day of Judgment. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command the angels to heat this money until it melts, to heat the gold and silver, these minerals, until they melt. And then these people will be branded by them after they are heated with that fire on their foreheads, on their flanks, and on their backs. This idea, this important idea of circulation is very important in our life. One of the very basic notions of life is circulating things. When there is no circulation, there is always a problem. When there is no circulation of air, there is always a problem. When there is no circulation of money, there is always a problem. When there is no circulation of goods, there is always a problem. And when there is no circulation of talents, there is always a problem. So if everyone kept his talents to himself without circulating and benefiting others with them, there will be a big problem in the society. When people withhold their money, there will be a problem in the society. When people withhold their goods, there will be a problem in the society. And that is why many societies suffer when those who have got talents are unable to circulate and benefit others with these talents. Imam Abdullah bin Alawi al-Haddad, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him and may Allah benefit us with his knowledge in this dunya and akhirah, has a very amazing intention when you sit for knowledge. He says, Nawaitu al-ilma wa ta'allum. I intend to learn and to give benefit, and to learn and to teach. Wa nawaitu al-tadhakkura wa al-tadhkir. And I intend to remember and to give remembrance. وَنَوَيْتُ الْإِفَادَةَ وَالْإِسْتِفَادَةَ. I intend to benefit and to give benefit. This issue of circulating, learning and giving, taking and giving, learning and teaching is very important. In the month of Ramadan, people, unfortunately, they don't circulate food. That's why we find in so many Muslim countries, people withhold a lot of food till the time of iftar, and then after iftar, the bins are full with our waste. This month of Ramadan and this ayah of the Quran teaches us that when you withhold things for yourself, there will be a lot of waste. And when there is a lot of waste, the society suffers. And because the natural circulation has not happened, we have to do recycling. After you have made the waste, you have to do recycling. So you have to recycle it to make it usable again. But had people been using it from the beginning, there would be no need for recycling. Had people been spending money for the sake of Allah and giving those who are in need, eating what is enough for them or preparing what is enough for them and distributing the rest for the rest of the society, there would be no need for recycling. There would be always circulation. And when there's circulation, there is benefit and there is health. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us this month of Ramadan, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَهُوَ شَهْرُ الْمُوَاسَةِ. This is the month of philanthropy and help and assistance. It is a month when people should go and share. It's the month of sharing. We learn in the month of Ramadan that in the month of Ramadan, instead of sharing as we should, we learn in the month of Ramadan to eat, to keep. It's the month of keeping rather than the month of sharing. If there is sharing, people will have no waste. But if there is keeping, there will be always waste. External waste, filling our bins, and internal waste, filling our hearts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us in this month from this shuh, this greed and stinginess. Stinginess is something that makes people withhold things, that makes people hoard money, that makes people keep for themselves, that makes people have a lot of waste. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from waste internally and externally. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. الحمد لله رب العالمين.